गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास, हाउ आर यू? फाइन, यस आई एम ऑल्सो फाइन हियर। सो वी आर नाउ रीडिंग आवर ट्राइंगल चैप्टर एंड वी आर एट द वर्ज ऑफ फिनिशिंग दिस चैप्टर। ओके, सो ऑलमोस्ट ऑल टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चंस वी हैव डिस्कस, वन टू आर इवन, सो वी डिस्कस टुडे ओनली एंड बी रेडी। इफ द टीचर्स आर नॉट देयर विथ यू देन यू कैन टेक हेल्प फ्रॉम दिस वीडियो एंड what we have to read is that we have read the different type of triangles. Okay, I hope you have not forgot that we have read this different type of triangles here. These are equilateral, isosceles, scalene, acute, obtuse and right angle triangle. Okay, we have read this. Then we have read, we have already discussed this median also. Okay, see, all these angles we have discussed, right? Acute, obtuse. Okay, so we have discussed about median also. Last class only we have discussed 1, 2, that is the line from the vertex which backs at the opposite, right? And the meeting point of all the median is called centroid. Okay, we have read this also. Then there is one more point that is called circumcircle. This we have not discussed. So what is circumcircle? Circumcircle is that, wait a minute, okay, first we discuss this in circle. In circle is that angle bisector is a straight line through a vertex to a triangle that divides the angle into two equal parts, that divide the angle into two equal parts. Okay, so that is called, this is what we have to use today in our video there, that angle bisector is a straight line through a vertex of a triangle that divides the angle into two equal parts, and the point where the three all meet is called in center, is called in center. Suppose this is the triangle and we have three angles, so their angle bisectors are here. This is the first angle bisector, this is the second angle bisector, this is the third angle bisector. Okay, so what is the meaning of angle bisector? It means that these and these angles will be equal, these and these angles will be equal. Okay, and this point here, this point is called in center of the triangle. Okay, this is what we have to read. Okay, then we have orthocenter of a triangle. What is the orthocenter of a triangle? So orthocenter of a triangle is the point where perpendiculars drawn from the vertex to the opposite sides of the triangle intersect each other. Okay, so that is called orthocenters. Okay, so what is orthocenter actually? So if this is the triangle here, suppose that, and these lines are perpendicular, these all lines are perpendicular, means we can say altitude there. So this is meeting point, this meeting point is only called orthocenter of the triangle. Okay, so on this I have made one video here and I would like to share with you. Just wait, I'm showing that. Here is this question, class. And the question says that if two parallel lines are cut by a transversal, then prove that the interior angles on the same side of the transversal intersect each other at right angles. You read that question nicely. I'm erasing these lines here. So this is the one question you read here. Now we are going to solve this. Okay, how we will solve? See how we will solve this question here. So first of all, what is given here? So first of all is given that, we'll draw the figure of that one. That is the two parallel lines are given. Okay. And these parallel lines are cut by a transversal. So we have cut this by the transversal. Then they are saying that the bisectors of the interior angles on the same side of the transversal. The bisectors of the interior angles. These are the interior angles. Okay. These are here the interior angles. See? A, B and O. These are the interior angles. And their bisector, this is the bisector here. See? This is the bisector of this angle here. BO is the bisector of this angle. AO is the bisector of this angle. Just now I have explained what is the meaning of angle bisector also. So we'll write all these informations here. First of all, what is given? L is parallel to M. See? L is parallel to M is given here. So we have written, and T is the transversal. This one is the transversal also. This one is the transversal. Transversal is the line which intersects the parallel lines at two unique points. So this is the transversal here. And then what? Then it is written that AO bisect angle AO. Basically AO bisect angle, that means angle 1 is equal to angle 2. I am mentioning also where is angle 1 and where is angle 2. So that is angle 1 is equal to angle 2. These two angles are equal only. And then OB bisect angle B. OB bisect angle B. That means angle 3 is equal to angle 4. See it? Angle 3 is equal to angle 4. What we have to prove? We have to prove that this one, we have to prove actually that this angle 1 here, this angle O is equal to 90 degree. And we have to prove this one only. See, I've written angle AOB is equal to 90 degree. And we are just going to prove this only. See, we have to prove angle AOB is equal to 90 degree. So let us start. We'll use the angle sum property of the triangle. That only the only one main tool we are having. So we'll use that property here in triangle ABO. Before that, we'll use the consecutive interior angle property. And it says that if the two lines are parallel, that means angle A plus angle B, this whole angle sum will be equal to 180 degree. Which angle? So this angle A and this angle B. So this is equal to, see, 180 degree. So their half will be also equal, obviously, their half will be also equal. And what is half of angle A? We have read this in the previous slide. I have explained half of angle A is angle 2 and angle 1 also, but I will take angle 2. And half of angle B is either angle 3 or angle 4, but I'll take angle 3. So now, this is one of the most important result, is that angle 2 plus angle 3 is equal to 90 degree. Remember this, okay? Now, we are going in triangle AOB. So in this triangle, angle 2 plus angle 3, angle 2 plus angle 3, plus angle AOB is equal to 180 degree. Same reason is that angle sum property of the triangle. We write that only, angle sum property. Okay, then just now we have found the value of angle 2 and angle 3. So that angle 2 plus angle 3 is equal to 90 degree. Okay, we have found in the previous board only. Okay, so angle 2 plus 90 degree and angle AOB is equal to, the sum of these two is equal to 180. Very good. So angle AOB is equal to 90 degree. So this is what we had to prove, and we have proved also. Okay, so this is what we had to prove, that angle AOB is equal to 90 degree. See, we have proved this angle is equal to 90 degree using the angle bisector of a triangle. Okay, so next class we'll learn something new. Till then, all of you take care. Thank you, class. Thank you very much.